माइनस थ्री इज स्मॉलर देन माइनस टू एंड माइनस फोर एंड जीरो जीरो इज मोर देन नेगेटिव इंटीजर्स दैट्स व्हाई माइनस फोर इज लेसर देन थ्री. ओके दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस गिवन इन द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. Now coming to the second question, write the following integers in increasing and decreasing order. So it is very simple. You can use another integers also. You can compare them also. No problem. Now coming to the second, writing the numbers in. Write the following integers. Write the following integers. In increasing and decreasing order, both the order. In increasing and decreasing order. And my first question is minus 7 comma 5 comma minus 3. And second question is minus 1 comma 3 comma 0. Okay, let us finish first these two problems. First problem solution. See, increasing order or decreasing order, what is meaning by that? Increasing order is nothing but ascending order. Decreasing order is nothing but descending order. If we are arranging the numbers small to big, that is increasing order. That is nothing but ascending. And if we are arranging the given numbers in the order from big to small, then that is known as decreasing order or descending order. So both we have to write for same question. So first I am writing increasing order. Increasing order in the sense ascending order only. Increasing, name only telling that. Small to big, increasing. Increasing order, so first problem. So increasing means we need to select the smaller values. So in case of integers, remember that whenever you are writing ascending order, first identify the negative integers, then zero, then positive. Negative, zero, and positive. If you are writing descending order, positive, zero, and negative. Okay. Now observe these three integers. Only three are given, so very simple. Now observe the given three integers. Here we have two negative integers, minus 7 and minus 3. Okay, because we are writing in increasing order, we have to choose a smaller value. That's why I am talking about negative integers first. Now, in case of minus 7 and minus 3, which one is the smaller one? Because of negative value, minus 7 is smaller than minus 3. So, minus 7 is my first integer. After that, automatically, next negative integer, that is minus 3 only. Minus 7 is lesser than, minus 3 is lesser than, and remaining integer is 5. That's all. So this is increasing order. If you have any doubt, just observe small to big we have arranged. Minus 7 is smaller than minus 3. And these two are negative integers. Negative integers always lesser than positive. If you are getting any one integer as 0, so you need to place between negative and positive. Always 0 you need to place between negative and positive integers. Okay. And coming to the decreasing order for the first problem only. Just increasing order, whatever you wrote, for that reversely if you are writing, that is a decreasing order. Means we need to arrange big to small. So whenever you are talking about decreasing order, first choose the positive integers. So here only one positive integer we have, that is 5. 5 is greater than, because we are writing decreasing, so greater than symbol we must use. Then choose the greater number among the remaining two, that is minus 3 or minus 7. Which one is greater? Minus 3. So minus 3 is greater than minus 7. That's all. Okay. Coming to the second problem. Increasing order. So as I told you, in case of increasing order, negative integers we have to choose first. Negative integer we have minus 1. Only one integer is there. So minus 1 is lesser than 0 also we have. So negative 0 and positive. There is no confusion. That's all. Negative 0 and positive. That's it. So minus 1 is lesser than 0 and 0 is lesser than 3. Minus 1, 0 both are lesser than 3. Okay. And coming to the decreasing order for the second problem. Just reverse the given whatever you have written, just reverse those numbers, that's all. So what we will get, 3 is greater than 0 is greater than minus 1. This is decreasing order. Okay. So like that only still two more problems are given. That those are third problem is 1, 3, minus 6. So write increasing order is equal to 1 is 1 and 3 both are positive. So while we are writing increasing order, first we have to choose negative. So minus 6 is lesser than, between 1 and 3, which one is smaller? 1 only. So 1 is lesser than 3. That's all. And decreasing order or descending order. So while you are writing descending order, we need to choose the positive integers. Here positive integers are 1 and 3. Among these two, 3 is greater. So 3 is greater than 1 is greater than minus. That's all. And coming to the fourth problem. Minus 5, minus 3, minus 1. All are negative given. Minus 5, minus 3, minus 1. And we need to write increasing order. So write completely here. Increasing order. Don't write sharp one. Increasing order we must write. So increasing order is equal to, what is all our negative values? So choose the smaller one among those. Minus 5, minus 3, minus 1. So minus 5 only smaller among these three integers. Minus 5 is lesser than remaining two also. Minus 3 only lesser and then minus 1. The given question only is in the increasing order. Now write the decreasing order. So here greater value among the given three integers is minus 1, greater than, next greater is minus 3, next greater value is minus 5. Okay. Next, the third problem is 'Write true or false, correct those that are false.' And my first problem is, sorry, first statement is, 0 is on the right of minus 3. 0 is on the write up minus 3. So is this true or false? We have to write. If it is false, we need to write the reason, correct answer also. And coming to the second question. Minus 12 and plus 12 represent. And the number line, same integer. And the number line, same integer. And coming to the next question. Every positive integer is greater than 0. Every positive integer is greater than 0. And next, fourth one. Minus 5 is lesser than 8. And fifth one, minus 100 is greater than plus 100. And next, minus 1 is lesser than minus 8. Okay, observe the given statements. We need to write it true or false. If those are false, we need to write the correct reason also. Now observe here, 0 is on the right side of minus 3 given. So first they are indicating 0 and minus 3. So just observe among 0 and minus 3, 0 only greater. So always greater values lies right side of the smaller value. Means 0 is right side of minus 3 is correct statement. So true. Remember, always greater values lies right side of the given number. So among 0 and minus 3, 0 only greater. So 0 is lying right side of minus 3. That is true. Coming to the second question. Minus 12 and plus 12 represent on the number line same integer. Just observe, minus 12 is negative integer, plus 12 is positive integer. Are they equal to represent same number? No. They, one is negative, so one number is lying left side and other number is lying right side on the number line. So those are, that statement is false, and the correct statement is that they are representing different numbers on the number line. Okay, minus 12 and plus 12 represent different integers on the number line. Okay, this is the correct reason. Correct, those that are false, they said. So this is the false statement. And what is the correct statement? They are representing different integers on the number line. Minus 12 is lying left side and plus 12 is lying right side. Now coming to the third one, every positive integer is greater than 0. Yes, every positive integer is greater than 0 as well as a negative integer. So it is true statement, no need to correct. And coming to these two values, minus 5 is lesser than 8. Always negative values are lesser than positive. So this is true. And minus 100 is greater than plus 100. Same reason. Here, negative integer given, but greater value is negative integer, they are sure. But we know that positive integers only always greater than negative integers and 0. So this statement is false, and the correct answer is minus 100 is lesser than plus 100. Yes. And coming to the last one, minus 1 is lesser than minus 8. So among the negative integers, smaller one only greater value. That means minus 1 is greater than minus 8, not smaller. So this answer also false. So once again observe, for the correct statements, no need to write any reason. Whatever false statements are there, we need to write the correct answer. So first statement is given, 0 is right side of minus 3. Yes, because 0 is greater than minus 3, so it is lying right side of minus 3 on the number line. And coming to the second question, minus 12 plus 12, both are representing same number on the number line, they are same. But minus 12 will be left side on the number line and plus 12 is on the right side on the number line. So they are representing different integers on the number line. So correct answer is minus 12 and plus 12 represents different integers on the number line. Okay. And third question, every positive integer is greater than 0. Yes, every positive integer is greater than 0 and negative number. So this statement is true. Coming to the fourth question, minus 5 is lesser than 8. Just now I told you, always positive integers are greater than negative integers. That is nothing but negative integers are smaller than positive. Yes or no? So always minus values are lesser than plus values. So for this statement is true. Minus 5 is lesser than 8 is true. So no need to write reason. Coming to the fifth one, minus 100 greater than plus 100 given. So it is false because negative values always lesser than positive. So that's only the reason. Minus 100 is lesser than plus 100. And last statement also, in case of negative integers, smaller one will be the greater, smaller value indicates greater value. Means minus 1 is greater than minus 8. So that is also false and correct reason is minus 1 is greater than minus 8. Next, fourth problem. Okay, observe the fourth problem here. Find all integers which lie between the given two integers. Which lie between the given two integers. also represent them on the number line.
Also represent them on the number line.
Okay, one by one we will do. My first problem is -1 and 1. So for this solution, first what we have to do, all the integers which are lying between these two integers we need to find, and also we have to represent them on the number line. So first of all, list the integers which are lying between -1 and 1. The integers, so just observe, between -1 and 1 only one integer is there. Which one it is? Just 0. So the integer which lie between, otherwise the integer lie between -1 and 1 is 0. So represent it on the number line. So for a number line, both check arrows compulsory because it is a line, and first indicate 0. Okay, for 0 all the right side values are positive, so 1, and next I want to represent -1. After that also we have the values, so because of arrows we no need to write. Just between -1 and 1 which values are lying, that one you need to represent, that's all. Okay, and coming to the second question, -5 and 0. So the integers, the integers lie between, lies between -5 and 0 are, so just observe here, only one integer is there, that's why it's 0. Now how many integers are there between -5 and 0? 0 to -5. Okay, greater value is 0 among these two. So 0 to -5, which values we are getting? -1, -2, -3, -4. Between 0 and -5 they are telling, between. If they are telling from, then we have to include these two values also. Between means just what values are there, which values are there in these two numbers. Between those two numbers we have to list. Means we no need to write 0 and -5. So which integers are there between 0 and -5? That is -1, -2, -3, and -4. So represent them on the number line. Just observe, given values all are lying left side only. So 0 and here +1. Left side -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. Which values they are indicated in the question? -5 and 0. So I have written -5, 0. Whatever values are there between them, I have shown on the number line. Just represent them. So all these values are lying between 0 and -5. -1, -2, -3, -4. Okay. Like there only remaining answers also. So first, third problem. And here I am writing third question. Third question is that -6 and -8. So between those two integers, which value is missing? Just one value only, that is -7. So the integer lies between -6 and -8 is -7. So represent it on the number line. -6, -7 and -8. While you are writing the negative numbers, left side you have to do -6, -7, -8. So -7 is there in between -6 and -8. And fourth problem. 0 and minus 3. Again, negative side only. Just observe 0, minus 3. So between those two values, which values are there? Observe this number line only. 0 and minus 3. Just minus 1 and minus 2 are there. So the integer lies between minus 0 and minus 3 are minus 1 comma minus 2. So represent them on the number line. 0 positive side only plus 1 I am taking, and left side minus 1 minus 2 minus 3, because I need to take till minus 3 only. Between 0 and minus 3, minus 2 minus 1 are lying. That's it. Okay, once again observe the question. Find the all the integers which lies between the given two integers they are asking. Not only that, whatever values you are getting, you have to represent them on the number line. So which type of number line they did not say, either horizontal or vertical. I have used horizontal number line in all these cases. Now, first question, minus 1 and 1. Between minus 1 and 1, we are getting only 0. Yes or no? So the integer lies between minus 1 and 1 is 0. And we are representing by using the number line. Coming to the second one, integers which are lying between 0 and minus 5, we have to write. Those are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So we have drawn the number line and we have indicated the integers between minus 5 and 0. Similarly, remaining two problems are. Okay. So remember, while you are writing positive, right side 1, 2, 3, 4 sequence you can write. But while you are writing with left side, like this you must write. See, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9. This side you have to go. Okay. See, if you are writing minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, that side, that is wrong. Okay. Now coming to the last problem. The temperature recorded in Shimla is
recorded in Shimla is -4 degrees Celsius and Kufri is -6 degrees Celsius and the same day. Okay. Which place is colder on that day? How? Which place is colder on that day? How? Okay, this is the last problem from this exercise 6.2, and after this we have addition and subtraction of integers. Okay, observe the problem. Temperature recorded in Shimla is -4 degrees Celsius. So first given statement, write down what is the temperature of Shimla. That is temperature of Shimla is equal to -4 degrees Celsius and Kufri is -6 degrees Celsius. Temperature of Kufri is -6 degrees Celsius. These are the two given values, and they are asking to find that on the same day these are the temperatures recorded in two different places. Which place is colder on that day? How? See, colder in the sense, if you are taking more temperature, that is hotter area, yes or no? And lesser temperature, if you are selecting lesser temperature, that will be the colder area, yes or no? See, now among these two, which integer is lesser value? That means comparison only here also. So -4, -6, among these two which one is smaller? Because both are negative, -6 is smaller. That means on that particular day Kufri is colder than Shimla. Understand? So because of how they have said now, because -6 degrees Celsius is lesser than -4 degrees Celsius. Okay, -6 degrees Celsius temperature is low temperature than -4 degrees Celsius. That means Kufri is having low temperature. Low temperature in the sense that will be colder area than Shimla. Yes or no? So therefore, Kufri is colder than Shimla because it is having less temperature. Or low temperature on that day. Temperature of Kufri is lesser than Shimla. So if the temperature is less, means that will be the colder area. That's why Kufri is colder than Shimla. Okay.
Now coming to the next topic, that is till now we discussed about what are integers, what are the different types of integers, and how to represent the integers on the number line, as well as how to compare the integers. Just previous in the previous exercise we have studied. Now we will apply what are the basic mathematical operations on integers. So total we have four operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Yes or no? So all those operations how we are applying on integers, now we will learn. So first, how to add the integers, how to subtract the integers. Those two topics only we have now. So we will learn how to add and subtract the integers. Before that, observe this. So we will learn how to add the integers by using the number line and without using the number line. Addition of integers. How to add the integers. So depending on this topic, the remaining problems are there in 6.3. So those problems we will practice tomorrow. Now observe the addition of integers. Actually, how we are adding. See, already I told you, like integers, integers which are having two integers which are having same sign. For suppose plus 2 and plus 5. Even 2 and 5 if I am writing, there is no problem because positive integers no need to indicate plus. So now 2 and 5 are both are positive, so those are said to be like integers. So whenever you are adding like integers, just go for addition operation. You see, remember, for normal addition and addition of integers, this one only the difference. Even here we are doing addition, we have to do subtraction also. How? Just observe. See, when we are adding two like integers, go for addition only. Means 2 plus 5 is equal to 7. And whatever sign they are having, that means both are like by plus sign. Yes or no? So use plus sign. And if I have both are negative integers, even though these two are also like integers, so in this case also we have to go for addition. 2 plus 5 is equal to 7. But because both are having minus sign, you need to keep minus 7. Remember, whenever you are getting like integers in case of addition, add those two values and keep which sign they are having. Okay? And if one is positive and one is negative, that means unlike integers. When you are getting unlike integers, in that case, you have to do subtraction. See, even if it is addition, we have to go for subtraction. That's only the difference in addition of integers. So 5 is the greater value here. The difference 5 minus 2 is 3. And which symbol we must keep? Here we know that 5 is more than 2. And 5 is having minus 10. So we need to keep minus 10. You have to put the greater number 10 after subtracting this. Okay, if I have minus 2 plus of plus 5. Even 1 is minus, 1 is plus. So negative and positive we are getting means unlike integers. So we have to go for subtraction. And 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. Here 5 is greater value among 5 and 2. And 5 is having plus 10. So my answer is plus 3. Okay, remember, whenever you are getting like integers, so only for two integers I am explaining, we can add more than two integers also. If the given integers are like integers, add, okay, add those integers and put whatever sign they are having. If given integers are unlike, then go for subtraction and put the greater symbol sign. So about this, tomorrow we'll discuss very clearly, and how to represent these values on the number line, that one also we will learn.
So just observe, just now I told you, if both are positive integers, then you need to go for addition and keep plus sign. We must add those two integers and we have to keep a plus sign. Okay. And if both are negative, then also we must go for addition. We have to keep minus symbol. If one is positive and one is negative, in this case, we have to go for subtraction and put the greater number sign. Okay, and if one is negative, one is positive. Same, positive and negative, negative and positive. We have to go for subtraction only, and we must keep the greater number sign. So this is addition table for two integers, only two integers. So if the given two integers are positive integers, we have to add those two positive integers, and we must keep plus sign. If both are negative integers, we have to go for addition and we must keep minus. And one is positive, one is negative, then we have to subtract those two integers and we have to keep greater number sign. If greater number is having plus sign, you have to put plus. If greater number is having minus sign, you need to keep minus sign. That's it. Okay. And next, see, this is for only two integers. If more than two integers are given, then how we have to add? That one we will discuss later on. So remember that what are they asking? See, if they won't give, for suppose directly they are giving minus 2 plus a plus 5. Like this, they are given two integers. And it is between integers. Here, minus 2 is one integer and plus 5 is one integer. So, first thing you need to identify which type of integers they are given. One is negative, one is positive. Means unlike integers they are given. Between those two integers, which operation is there? Plus. Plus is nothing but addition. Okay. In case of addition, what you have to do, if both are negative or positive, we have to go for addition. If both are unlike, in that case, we have to go for subtraction. So minus 2 and plus 5 are unlike integers. We need to go for subtraction. So 5 minus 2 is 3. And here we must keep greater number sign. So here 5 is having plus sign, so we need to keep the result plus. Okay. See, for suppose I have minus 70 plus minus 30. Two integers are there. Now observe, minus 70 and minus 30 are negative, means like integers. Between them we are having addition operation. So while we are adding two like integers, while we are performing addition between two like integers, we need to add those two values. Means minus 70 minus 30 is equal to 100 actually. 70 plus 30 is 100. Both are minus values, so minus 100. Okay. So that's what I am telling. When you are adding like integers, go for addition and keep the, if they are having plus sign, you must keep plus. If they are having minus sign, you must keep minus. And one is positive, one is negative. Means in case of unlike integers, we need to go for subtraction and we must keep the greater number sign. So this table is very, very important. And this is addition table. Okay. Depending on this topic, we will discuss the different problems in the tomorrow's class.